Have you heard of an EV battery that could cost only about $10 per kilowatt hour and offer a staggering 3.6 million miles of performance? Well, that's what CATL has been working on, and now it is ready for distribution. Before this battery fully hits the market, this video will expose details about this battery that you should know. First, let's talk about the cost of this battery. Recently, lots of reports have said that CATL's new sodium-ion battery could cost only $10 per kilowatt hour. How realistic could this be? Let's take a closer look. Could the $10 per kilowatt hour battery proposal be true? When CATL introduced its sodium ion battery in April 2025, lots of news reports spread very exciting numbers. Some said the batteries could cost 50% less than lithium ion, and a few even claimed 90% cheaper. Those are huge numbers, but are they true? Experts like S&P Global Mobility and Benchmark Mineral Intelligence say that when sodium-ion batteries are made in large amounts, they might be about 20 to 40% cheaper than lithium-ion batteries. For example, making a lithium-ion battery costs about $70 per kilowatt-hour, while a sodium-ion battery might cost around $50 per kilowatt-hour. That's cheaper, yes, but it's not half the price. So, the big 50% to 90% claims are probably exaggerated. Before we continue, like and subscribe to be the first to view more of our videos. The $10 per kilowatt hour figure that made headlines is more of a long-term goal than something happening right now. CATL hasn't yet shown that they can make batteries that cheap in actual production. So, is the sodium-ion battery really 50% to 90% cheaper than lithium-ion today? The answer is no. Right now, sodium-ion is only a little cheaper, and the $10 per kilowatt-hour number is something to aim for in the future, not today. Let's delve into another set of talking points that have arisen in recent times about these sodium-ion batteries by CATL. Yes, and that is in the area of its energy density. Energy density. One of the biggest complaints about sodium-ion batteries was their low energy density. According to scientists, sodium atoms are larger and heavier than lithium atoms, which makes it hard for engineers to pack a lot of energy into a small space. As a result, sodium-ion batteries weren't considered as suitable EV battery materials because weight and size are very important in an EV setup. But CATL's new 175 watt-hour per kilogram design changes the game. Thanks to this battery manufacturer, sodium-ion can compete with lithium iron phosphate, which is already the dominant battery type in most EVs. Looking back, for years, sodium-ion batteries from smaller companies like Hina Battery or Faradion could only achieve around 100 to 160 watt-hour per kilogram, which limited their use to small energy storage systems, rather than NEVs. But CATL 175 watt-hour per kilogram has changed the story for sodium-ion batteries, which can now be used in EVs. This move didn't just happen overnight. It was born from collaborations, discussions, and partnerships with stakeholders in the EV world. For example, in 2023, CATL partnered with Chery Automobile to release the first car powered by sodium-ion batteries. Even while this was going on, other EV battery manufacturers weren't even thinking of utilizing sodium-ion as a source of power for EVs. Yet, moves like this showed CATL's commitment to taking the lead in turning new ideas into practical products, as they've done in the past. Another point taken about the CATL's new battery innovation has been the miles of coverage. There have been several reports about this battery. Let's consider what we know. When people hear about a new electric car battery that could last 3.6 million miles, it almost sounds like science fiction. Yet, this is the type of claim that has been linked to CATL's new Nextra sodium-ion battery. But how true is this? At its Tech Day 2025 event, CATL unveiled the Nextra sodium-ion battery, which has been making headlines around the world. The company explained that this new technology offers more than 10,000 charging cycles. You'll agree that this is a big leap compared to most lithium-ion batteries currently used in electric vehicles, which could have a cycle span between 1,000 and 3,000 cycles. So, where did the widely quoted figure of 3.6 million miles come from? The math is quite simple. If one battery cycle provides about 360 miles of driving range, which is similar to what some of today's best EVs can achieve, then multiplying this by 10,000 cycles gives a total of 3.6 million miles. This means that, in theory, an EV equipped with this battery could keep running for several centuries if used under perfect conditions. However, at this point, what we should really pay attention to is not the exact number, but the fact that CATL's sodium-ion battery could last much longer than today's lithium-ion batteries. As already mentioned earlier, most lithium-ion batteries can handle around 1,000 to 3,000 cycles, but CATL is saying that their sodium-ion version can go beyond 10,000 cycles. So, instead of focusing too much on the 3.6 million miles figure, The main point is that this new battery technology has the power to change the future of electric vehicles, as a result, making them last much longer than we are used to today. A remarkable way in which the Nexter battery beats this lithium battery is the fact that a typical lithium-ion battery in an electric car can last about 1,500 to 3,000 charging cycles before it drops below 80% of its original capacity. In real-world driving, this usually equals between 200,000 and 500,000 miles. For instance, a Tesla Model 3 can last around 300,000 to 500,000 miles before its battery needs replacement or shows major performance loss. By comparison, CATL's new Nexter sodium-ion battery is designed to last far longer. Even if the real-world figure ends up being much lower due to factors like temperature and road conditions, the battery could still reach between 1.2 million and 1.8 million miles. This is 3 to 6 times longer than most lithium-ion batteries on the market today. Enough of the Nexter battery talk. There's another battery product made by CATL that has been specifically made for solving the harsh weather struggles faced by most EV batteries. That is the CATL Freevoy battery. Freevoy hybrid battery by CATL, China's top battery maker. CATL may have found the final solution to temperature disruptions noticed in EV batteries. What makes this battery special is that it doesn't just use lithium-ion cells like most electric vehicles today. Instead, it combines lithium-ion and sodium-ion cells into one pack, creating what is called an AB battery system. The essence of mixing these two battery types is basically to complement each other. According to CATL, this battery system improves cold weather driving range by about 5% compared to traditional lithium-only batteries. That means if a normal EV loses a big chunk of its range in winter, a car with Freevoy could keep going longer. This technology also solves the issue of EV battery aging quickly. In CATL's Freevoy design, stress is shared between the two types of cells. To simply put, the sodium-ion cells take on the harder job of cold weather performance, while lithium-ion cells handle the everyday driving performance. With this combination in place, this could mean the battery pack in the Freevoy hybrids lasts much longer than traditional lithium-only packs. Right now, engineers are still studying the exact numbers of the battery, but there is a strong belief that this hybrid setup would extend EV battery lifespans. The team at CATL has no doubt developed something that could change the EV battery industry forever. However, these are the concerns that they should be worried about, especially for the sodium-ion battery adoption. Concerns about the new CATL sodium-ion battery. 1. Adoption speed. Recall that when electric cars first came out, many people doubted them. At that time, drivers were worried about short ranges, long charging times, and whether batteries would even last a few years. Later, it took effort and investment from Tesla, BYD, and other companies over a decade of proven models on the road before EVs started to become mainstream. In a similar way, CATL should be worried about whether its sodium-ion battery innovation could face the same skepticism. We are talking about situations where automakers would hesitate to redesign their cars for this new technology without seeing how it performs in the real market. On the other hand, governments, too, will want safety certifications and proof that sodium batteries are reliable for buses, taxis, and trucks before pushing policy incentives. Without that, adoption could be much slower, even if the science is sound. However, if this pulls through, what does the future hold for the CATL sodium-ion battery? We can say the future is bright. What does the future hold for CATL? Well, for drivers, if CATL's sodium-ion batteries perform anywhere close to the numbers being promised, the everyday car owner will feel the difference first. If sodium-ion batteries really last thousands more cycles, that means drivers might not need to worry about replacing the battery at all during the car's lifetime. Imagine buying a car in 2025 and still driving it in 2050 with the same battery. That's something every driver looks forward to. Drivers will get peace of mind, savings, and vehicles that could last for decades instead of just years. On the other hand, for other automakers, this could mean more. You see, car makers spend billions each year on warranty issues from customers, and a big percentage of that comes from battery problems. If CATL's sodium-ion battery proves durable, automakers could reduce those costs by a large amount. With these Nexter and Freevoy hybrid batteries, we can't deny that CATL has achieved something remarkable. Just a few years ago, many people thought sodium-ion batteries were impossible to make. Now, CATL is not only proving they can work, but also making them good enough for real vehicles. However, we need to remember that for sodium-ion batteries to truly succeed, they need to survive real testing and win the trust of automakers. While we wait for this to happen, be assured that this channel will bring you all the updates as they unfold.